I'm going to present you today how to make a 9-volt battery pack rechargeable using 1850 cell. So let's get started. Everybody knows what's a 9-volt battery. Should look like this, and it's got around 9 volts. It's used in loads of application, and today we're going to build one using 1850 cell. Alright, so let's dive in. First we're going to choose some 1850 cell. Yeah. Let's choose randomly two of these. Okay, first step is to charge the batteries and discharge them using an IMAX B6 charger. I got a video here, you can click it, and we're gonna check the capacity. Next step, after you check the capacity, you have to group them according to have a similar or next to the same capacity. All right, like this one, although they are the two manufacturers, one is 740 milliamps and the other one is 455. So close, not ideal, but close. All right, so the next thing, we're gonna need some parts, you know. We have the batteries already. Now we're gonna need some two battery holders like this one for single cell as well. Some wires. Okay, and we're gonna use this old battery, a 9-volt battery, to take off this special connector. All right, so stay tuned. Next step is to remove this metal wire, which is covering the battery, to retrieve this special connector. This is very easy. With a plier, you can do it. This thing is quite stubborn, so. Here you go, we have managed to peel up a little bit, and then we're gonna go across and peel off the excess metal. If you want to have a look inside, a 9-volt battery is the same thing like we are trying to replicate. Here you go, inside the battery is multiple cells, put it in series and with this connector. So we're gonna replicate the same thing, but instead of multiple cells, we're gonna use just two lithium ion cells, rechargeable one, put them in series. All right, so we have recovered the contact here. We can use it as it is, or in this project, I'm gonna cut it away, like so, from here, and we're gonna strip the thingies, because it's kind of big, yeah? So here you go. This one normally is the plus and this one is the minus. But a very important step now. We're gonna connect this thing the other way around. Meaning this one is gonna be the negative and this one is gonna be the positive. Because when you're gonna connect the same type of connector to this one, it's gonna be reversed to your load. Yeah, so be very careful and keep that one in mind. All right, friends, we have the connector. Now, with our two battery holders, we're gonna put this one with the plus facing this way, so plus, minus, the other one, plus and minus. Basically, you have these batteries, yeah? They're gonna be connected like so. So, plus and minus is gonna come up from here, and in between is gonna be this connector over here. Okay, so I told you plus, minus, and plus, and minus. We're gonna apply some hot glue onto the things. Just a little bit to hold it in place, not much, just like so. And we're gonna press it against each other, stack it. Alright, so we have put some glue on the top as well, and now on this part here, we're gonna take the wire that I showed you early, if I'm gonna find it. Okay, now we have the wire as well. And how I told you, plus and minus, and this one over here. So we're gonna take this bit of wire, we're gonna wrap it one time under this pin. And maybe twice, and then across the second one as well, two times. We're gonna cut the excess wire, which is this one
and this one over here,
and we're gonna put some solder onto it.
Just put some solder to make them permanent, if it's gonna work, which it should. Takes a few seconds to warm up. There you go. Okay. The other terminal as well. I choose this kind of configuration from the rest that I saw on the internet, because this one is easily replaceable. The cells, you can change them if they're not working, recharge them as well, and you can make all sorts of configurations. So that's a plus. And if you want, you can make a split connection here, and you're gonna have like a double power bank as well, but it's up to you.
All right, now we're gonna take the connector and we're gonna put some solder onto it.
Not that much. I'm gonna put some solder onto the connector, and then we're gonna attach the thingies to the batteries. We're gonna try to fill this blob here in the middle. Seems all right, it seems more steady. There you go. And on this side as well, we're gonna fill this blob, this small one. Let's put some compound as well. Come on, fill it up. Okay, ducky. And now we're gonna take our piece of wire that's left, and we're gonna connect it in the tiny blob there. And then we're gonna check for polarity and all that stuff, you know. So I'm gonna try to stick it inside the blob. It's kind of tricky. Come on, friend. Doing this, we're gonna put a blob more into that hole as well. Arsh, a key nail, man. Yeah, do not touch the soldering iron when it's hot. Ah, a key nail, man. You heard that.
Okie dokie. We're gonna proceed now to the next contact, the next blob. Hopefully we're not gonna touch the soldering iron again. And we're gonna try to stick this other piece of wire, or the other end of the wire, in this tiny hole. Come on, lad. So tight. That's it. Okay, and now we're gonna take the connector after he did cool down a little bit. We're gonna put it like so, and we're gonna twist one time on this side. But wait, we didn't check it which one is which. All right, so we said that's plus and minus. All right, so plus. Normally, when this one is connected to the battery, this is the minus and this is the plus, but we have it right, which should be the other way around. This big one is gonna be the plus, but when it's gonna connect to the load, it's gonna be minus. Yeah, so plus and minus. Yeah, we have them all right. Okay, so we are good. We're gonna proceed by twisting this one. One time this part and one time this part. Maybe two times here if it's gonna have enough. Then we're gonna cut it in the middle. Plus or minus. Then we're gonna twist this one. We're gonna cut the excess wire as well, here and there. And we're not gonna solder it straight away, because we're gonna need to put some hot glue on the back here to make this one steady as well. All right, friends, before we're gonna make it this one permanent, let's have a test and try it. All right, we said here, this is the plus. We're gonna put it like so. Plus and minus, and this one is gonna be like so inside here. Let's check this terminal connections to see if we got 8 volts or so, plus or minus, because they are kind of drained. Here you go, 8 volts sharp. Take in mind that any 9 volts battery is shit, so as soon as you're gonna connect the load, it's gonna drop to 7.5 as well.
Alright, so we got it all good. No heating up, no problems. We're gonna remove the batteries, as I told you. And now we're gonna just apply some hot glue. You go onto the back here to not touch each other and to be able to stick them to this case as well, to be nice and sturdy. Here you go, nice and sturdy. If you want, you can add on all sides a little bit of glue, but it's up to you and how pretty you want to be. Then we're gonna proceed by soldering the remaining two connections here, and we are next to finish. Alright, next thing, we're gonna solder these connections. Should be very straightforward and easy explanatory. Just add solder to one connection and to the other as well, and then preferably afterwards, you know, isolate them somehow with electrical tape or whatever you have on hand to prevent any short in a future. Okay. Alright, so our project is next to finish. Here it is. As long as you're gonna take in mind this connection plus here, minus and plus and minus over here, that's gonna be your thingy. Okay, let's test it one more time. As I told you, plus and minus, minus and plus. Okay, doesn't make any sparks, any booms, any nothing. Now, so should be working. Let's measure now the voltage, because now it's a steady thing. We have it all connected. There you go. Yeah, 8 volts sharp. Sharp, my friends. Now, let's connect some load. Yeah, we got this LED bulb, which is a 12 volts one, but it's unpolarized, so it doesn't matter which way I'm gonna connect it. Let's see. Can I do something? I'll be able to touch the wires. Here you go. Here you go, friends. It's working as a charm. Yeah, I'm gonna connect it the other way. Ta-da! Working. Something else? An LED strip, maybe. This is minus. Let me check. Yeah. So this is minus and this is plus. Here you go. It's working. A little bit dim, but it is what it is. That means the battery is discharged. But nonetheless, we're gonna make it work. And you can charge your phone as well. Thanks all for watching, friends. In the meanwhile, thumbs up, subscribe, share the fun, and enjoy this rechargeable 9-volt battery pack from Lithium cells. Yeah, nice. See ya.